My name is James Williams, Jr., and I'm about to talk to y'all on a slightly sensitive matter, if you will. I would call it a sensitive matter. I have a big-time issue, and it's mostly about me. I'm a people pleaser. I need to know how to stop being a people pleaser. I had a little incident this weekend about trying to share my father's remains, which caused a big old clusterfuck of problems between me and my stepsister and her child. Now, I'm gonna be polite, you know. I'm not gonna put their names out there, none of that shit, because I'm not into embarrassing people. I'm never into embarrassing people, because that's not what I do. As I get really pissed off. I'm not pissed off. I'm a little mad, but I'm not really totally, truly pissed off. Alright? So, one, I got some really bad text messages. That shit won't cool. Because I would never have ever done that to either one of them. I would never disrespect them. I would never talk to them in that manner or any of that other BS. It happened. Alright? So, now that I got that off my chest, let me elaborate on some of the things that my father done in his death. In his death, he has caused a big old clusterfuck. Alright? Don't get me wrong, I love my dad. And I don't like having problems. I don't like conflict unless it's with someone that I actually can hit. And I don't hit females. Because no real man should ever hit a female. No matter what comes out their mouth or whatever is said and done. Alright? Yeah, I still have long hair. I just didn't feel like fracking with it today. So, I got one of my booty caps. Now, I'm generally all around a fairly decent person to get along with. And granted, I'm not successful at damn near anything, except for fighting. It's probably the only thing I'm ever going to be successful at. I'm not successful in love. I'm not successful in life. And God knows my acting career will probably never take off. Got that out of my system too. But there comes a point in time when the people pleaser has to put his foot down or up. Just depends on how you look at it. So as the weekend unfolded, you know, yeah, I was thinking I was doing a good thing by dividing my father's ashes amongst my brother, my cousin, and my stepsister, and myself, because no one else really wanted the ashes. Well, apparently, my dad leaving us in this clusterfuck stage of, I'm going to tell my son one thing, I'm going to tell my stepdaughter another thing, which causes a fuck. Conflict. So I'm going to be complicit. I'm going to give her all the ashes except for what I have given away to my brother, his biological son, like me, the second biological son, and his nephew, who was like a son to him, was probably more of a son to him than I was. So that seems to have caused some kind of a fucking problem because I don't know what my dad told her. Now you see where the conundrum and the clusterfuck comes in. Alright? The clusterfuck comes in because we're not all on the same page here. No, I don't know what we're saying when I'm in Charlottesville and he's in Richmond with my stepsister. So what am I supposed to do? I can't reach beyond the stars and the grave to find out what was supposed to be done. Alright? When you got somebody telling you this and telling someone else something else, that does not put you at fault. That just means you have a lack of knowledge. It doesn't make you stupid. It just means you don't know. But if they tell you this and they've told someone else something else, how are you supposed to know what is real and what is not? I done what I was told. Period. Point blank, period. Rather, what he told her, he didn't tell me. What he told me, he didn't tell her. So granted, I don't like playing the blame game on a fucking dead man who died a year ago and 4 days ago, which would be on the 24th of March, which is this month. But at the same time, you can't fault me for wanting to keep a piece of my dad. But since it's gonna be such a big freaking issue, I'm going to be complacent and give her the damn ashes. Because you know what? In the end, it ain't hurting me to be selfless, alright? It ain't. It really ain't hurting me to be selfish at all. So, sister dear, and stepniece that cussed me out in yay so many words about being four letters or foul, you will have those ashes. All except for the one that I have already given away to my younger brother and my cousin. You can take them, or you can leave them, or you can flush them down the damn toilet. I really don't give a damn anymore. I'm tired of fighting. I'm done fighting losing battles. I'm done fighting people that I can't hit back. I'm done being complacent. I'm done being a people person. I discussed it with my Aunt Ruth. And she's with me on that. Give her the ashes. Done. You will have both. Not one, but both of these urns. Come next month, they will be yours. Without hesitation, without reservation, nothing. They will be yours. They will be sitting on your porch. Look for them. I'm not going to mail them to you. I'm going to hand deliver them to you. I don't know what day it's going to be on, but it's going to be on a school day. You'll probably be at work, so they should be safe on your front porch unless you have thieves in your neighborhood. Of course, I don't think anybody would want to steal dead people's remains. Then again, you'd be surprised at the shit that people will steal. But clearly, since I've caused the clusterfuck of a problem, I'm going to solve the clusterfuck of a problem, or at least as best I can. And you can do with them whatever you will. That doesn't solve the problem? Well, shoot me, burn me, then you'll have more ashes. I don't really give a rasp to you. They're just ashes. You can't bring them back once they're gone. I'm not going to fight you over my dad's remains. If you want them that bad that it's going to cause a problem, but your daughter decides to text me evil text messages and basically telling me that I am a piece of shit. But this piece of shit's going to show you that I'm a bigger piece of shit than you think. I'm going to give you all but what I gave away already. My half, your half, if you want any more, kill a bird, put it in there, burn it up, whatever. But you'll have all of them. I won't have anything but pictures, and that's fine with me, because you know what? In the end, it's just ashes. And there's nothing left of my dad but bones and ashes. And I'm not going to fight you over that, because I don't know what he told you. And what he told you, I've never seen you lie to me, and I have no reason to lie to you, but I know he didn't tell me to do anything with the ashes. All right? He didn't say nothing to me about ashes, because he wasn't planning on dying. But apparently, he talked to you. Didn't ask me about how I felt about it or anything. Apparently, he just told you that he wants the ashes with your mom's ashes. And I will comply. Except for what I already gave away. Because I'm not taking nothing back from my younger brother. I'm not taking nothing back from my cousin. We do have the right to have some of him. Period. So you shall have the ashes. What you do with them afterwards, it's on you. But don't worry, I'm never coming back for them. Once you have them, they're yours. They're going to be your problem. It's not going to be something I'm going to cry and fight about. It's just ashes. I have him right here. That's all I need. So you will have him in possession. You will be totally held responsible for him. You better take care of him. That's all I got to say on that. We're still cool. We're good. Happy trails with that. And I'm done. My name is James Williams Jr. This is Comfy Havoc 2. Good night, everyone.